surfs up. Learn to ride the F&O waves only on Bloomberg Quint with Agam Vakil.
Hello and welcome to Surf's Up with me, Agam Vakil, on Bloomberg Quint, and this is your place to get weekly updates and outlook on trades in India's equity F&O markets. The Federal Reserve's move on US interest rates was perhaps the final known trigger for equity markets in 2016. One more event down, one more event disregarded by market participants. Major indices are where they were last week, with the Nifty holding steady well above 8,200, and the VIX has quietened down and consolidation has resumed. But as we go into the last 2 weeks of the year, is it likely to remain quiet? Let's find out. Joining us back and taking us through these ups and downs and perhaps recommending plays in the futures and options space this week is Gaurav Bissa, derivatives analyst at LKB Securities. Thanks for joining us again, Gaurav. And I know that you have been tracking a lot of opportunities last week, despite the fact that Nifty has come back to where it is. I'm going to ask you, and I'm, you know, starting with, where is the Nifty headed now, at least for the next 5 to 6 sessions? Are you expecting it to remain range-bound?
Hi, thanks for having me on board. As far as Nifty is concerned, we are of the opinion that Nifty will continue to trade in a range. So if you look at the option data, 8,000 put commands, one of the highest OI concentration, and 8,300 call option commands, one of the highest OI concentration. This implies that more or less the Nifty will trade in a range. So what we are advising to our clients is either selling 8,000 put and 8,300 call option, that strategy is called a strangle, or 8,200 call and put combined, even that can be a decent strategy for next few days. And I think that is the safer strategy, because if you look at buying either call or put, if you carry it for a day or two, I don't think the chances are very high to make money.
Fair enough, Gaurav. So I'm assuming that also means that you are not expecting the Nifty to go beyond 83 on the upside.
Well, yes, for next few days at least, I don't see any trigger to take Nifty above 8,300 or below 8,000 levels.
And is it the same for the Nifty Bank as well? Is that what your expectations are?
Well, yes. What we are observing that 18,150 spot levels are very strong supports for the index. And Bank Nifty has been reversing from those levels. So I would be a buyer around the 18,200 spot levels. On the other hand, 18,700 is a very, very strong resistance. Around those levels, one can either sell. Again, Nifty Bank is also in a range. So I don't expect a big breakdown or breakout coming in. I would not anticipate. If there's a breakdown below 18,150, I'll short. Breakout above 18,700, I'll go long.
Okay, so Gaurav, tell us about some stock futures or stock option ideas for the coming week.
For stock futures, I think one should have a view or have some exposure in Indraprastha Gas Limited, IGL. We are seeing some strong long positions getting built. It's come out of the consolidation range. And if 880, if we close the week above 880, I expect 10% move coming in. So with a small surplus of 860, one can go long on IGL. And second would be a trading call would be on Reliance Capital. We are seeing good amount of long positions getting built. Another stock to come out of consolidation with a small stop loss of 439 percent stop loss. One can go long. Targets would be 460. So it's a lucrative risk reward. And among the options, buying Hindustan Zinc 300 call option would make sense. We are seeing a good breakout along with good amount of long positions getting built. So one can have a view on that as well. And for the weaker ones, I think LIC Housing is quite weak. One can sell, have a stop loss of 555, play for targets of 535.
Excellent. So you have 4 ideas, guys, from Gaurav Bissa this week. But Gaurav, I'm going to come down to Derivatives 101. And once again, I'm going to remind our audiences as well that we are open and inviting questions for our guests. So Gaurav, the question for this week is from Sanjay Shah, who asks, what is a covered call and when do you use a covered call?
Okay, so the basic premise for covered call is that you try to partially hedge your positions. Say if you are long on IGL, as I said, you go long on IGL futures. There's a considerable risk if you go long on future or you go short on futures, unlimited risk sort of. So what one can do, one can buy IGL futures quoting at 890 and sell 920 call option. So it is partially hedging. The delta of futures is 1. 920 call option delta would be around 0.35, around those levels. So net debt, you are long 0.65. So at least you have partially hedged your delta. What it means is that if there's a fall in IGL or if there's a fall in futures from 890, it becomes 870 or 875. You have a loss of 15 rupees in futures, and your call option, 920 call option, let's say you sold it at 15 rupees, that will also become 7 rupees, 8 rupees. So you will not lose entire 15 rupees, you will lose 7 to 8 rupees. And it becomes very interesting because the lot sizes have increased so much. From 250,000 per lot size, it has now become 8 lakh to 9 lakh, 10 lakh in many cases. So it becomes very lucrative. Again, I would say, utilize this strategy toward the end of the expiry, because at that point of time, you can have benefit of arbitrage sort of as well. Initially, options are priced very high, so it's not a lucrative strategy in beginning of series.
That's right, Sanjay. I hope that answers your question. And I think the crucial takeaway also is what a lot of people will not know, as Gaurav has mentioned, that a better time to execute a covered call is towards the end of the expiry. That can be most critical. But that is all that we have for today on Surf's Up. Thanks again for coming and joining us, Gaurav, today as well, and simplifying some of that data for our audiences. And as for you listeners, you can always come back next week and join me, Agam Vakil, on yet another edition of Surf's Up on Bloomberg Quint. Thank you.